Then the 2021 St. Stephen's Men's Acts team has room for you. Please consider serving on this ministry as they prepare for the upcoming retreat in October of this year. See the bulletin for contact information. Second collection is for the Assumption. Today's Mass intention is for Stephen Lee Waldron by a mother and sister. Please stand as we welcome our celebrant, Father Kevin, singing Hail Holy Queen on page 425.
We are mindful of our sins, and so now we turn to Him and ask Him for forgiveness. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary and the Virgin, and all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you.
the ever-living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers of her glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me?" For at that moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears. The infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled. And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked upon his lowly servant. For this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm, and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months, then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We're celebrating the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. But why? Why are we celebrating this? And more importantly, what does this celebration have to do with me? In today's Solemnity, we celebrate and give glory to God for redeeming Mary and allowing her to share completely in the glory of her Son. We as Catholics firmly believe that at the end of Mary's life, she was assumed into heaven, that is, taken up body and soul, and is now with her Son in eternal glory. You see, the Church first began celebrating this feast actually way back when, in the second century, just after the first generation of Christians had passed away. But it was only dogmatically proclaimed as an article of the faith that we as Catholics actually firmly believe this not too long ago in 1950. By Pope Pius XII. So today, we're celebrating Mary's Assumption, but the focus is not so much on Mary as it is on what God has done in her. That through Jesus' death and resurrection, he has fully and uniquely redeemed her and did not allow her body to undergo the corruption of the tomb. Cool stuff, right? Good for Mary. But the temptation is to kind of leave it at that, right? Just to kind of say like, "Oh, cool, good for her, that's awesome." Just like as if, you know, a friend of mine came up and said, "Hey, Father Kevin, my buddy Jimmy just won the lottery." I'd be like, "Cool, good for him." And then I would just kind of go on with my day. We're invited to something a little bit deeper. Today's feast is so much more than just about Mary, as we said. And it's so much more about what God did for her. Today's solemnity is about you. How? These words might be familiar. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. It's the final words of the Apostles' Creed. What we celebrate today as Mary is what we are called to one day experience. Listen to this beautiful quote. It's from the Catechism that the Church gives us about today's solemnity. It says, finally, the Immaculate Virgin, preserved free from all stain of original sin, when the course of her earthly life is finished, was taken up body and soul into heavenly glory, exalted by the Lord. That's the cool stuff. Like, good for her. Awesome. But then it says, the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin is an anticipation of the resurrection of other Christians. Us. So you see, there's this popular belief out there that when we die, we go to heaven, that we're angels. We don't believe that as Catholics. Because just as Mary was taken up body and soul, we believe in the resurrection of the body. At the end of time. So you will have your body returned to you. The body is something good and holy. It's a part of who you are. The body is not just the shell that we're living in this earthly life. But this body, when we get to heaven, will be glorified and perfected. Because you see, in heaven, we will experience all the goodness of this earth in a perfected state. Think about that. All the things that you truly love here in this life. Think of a good wine, a conversation with friends, a beautiful friendship, a loving relationship, a mud-covered dirt bike. I don't know what you like. Whatever you like, all of this will meet you again, in a way, in a perfected state in heaven. You know, there's so much we don't know about heaven, what it's like, what it's going to look like. But we do know that we're not just going to be these wisps of air with wings kind of floating around, strumming on harps for all eternity. That sounds boring. No, heaven is what your heart truly is longing for. The physical glory of heaven is what you were made for. And you were called to this glory because you were willed into existence by God who loves you intimately, deeply. Who uniquely created you with all your quirks and dreams, your likes and dislikes, and he made you for eternal happiness with him in heaven, where Mary now shares in that happiness. So here on earth, of course, we strive against sin. We experience hardship, suffering, pain, and death. And we experience all that because of the original sin of Adam and Eve. And of course, we see all this hardship in our lives, right? I mean, just look at today. Our world is in a bit of chaos. The Delta variant is raging throughout the country. People are worried about climate change. Our political world is just people fighting against one another. There's so much confusion and hatred. And God does not deliberately will these things to happen, but he does allow them to happen. For one, he allows them to show that they are big reminders that this world and our hearts are in need of redemption. They're in need of God's redemption, his resurrection. Because you see, the answers and the happiness we look for can only be found in him. One of my favorite philosophers, he's a guy called Joseph Pieper. He's a Catholic who wrote a little bit about happiness. On one occasion, he spoke about how we were made for the eternal. We were actually made for heavenly glory. But we look for it in the wrong places. He says, man as he is constituted, endowed as he is with a thirst for happiness, we're all looking for happiness, cannot have this thirst quenched in the finite realm here on earth. And if he thinks and behaves as if that were possible, he is misunderstanding himself. He is acting contrary to his own nature. Mary, who responded to the word of God and whose soul magnifies the Lord, we were made for the eternal. So strive for the eternal. Today's solemnity tells us to look to Mary, who is the first to be fully redeemed by her Son, Jesus Christ. To look to her, ask for her prayers, and strive for the glory she has received from her Son. Stop looking for earthly fulfillment and happiness. You won't find it. To close, I'll leave us with a quote that the church gives us about today in a document called Lumen Gentium. It says, in the meantime, the mother of Jesus, in the glory which she possesses in body and soul in heaven, is the image and beginning of the church, us, as it is to be perfected in the world to come. Likewise, she shines forth on earth until the day of the Lord shall come, a sign of certain hope and comfort to the pilgrim people of God. You were made for eternity, my friends. Don't settle for anything less. In the joy of the glory that awaits us with Mary in heaven, we now profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father from all ages, begotten of God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the glory and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. God,
raised body and soul to glory, Mary shines forth as a great sign of our eternal future as the church. But we are still pilgrims as we bring our prayers with her to God our Father.
For the church, that we will look forward to the resurrection promised us by Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For world leaders, that they will always work for peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For devotion to Mary, that Christians may find unity around the lowly handmaiden, exalted to glory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our families, that the gentle Queen of Peace may reign in every home, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those special intentions that we hold dear to our heart, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the dead, that they will rise with Christ to rejoice forever with Our Lady and the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord of heaven and earth, our prayers come before you. With the help of the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, the first believer called to share in the glory of your triumphant Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Sing with us in the offertory song 691, 691, praise the Lord, my soul, 691.
my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all the Holy Church.
May this oblation of our tribute of homage rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts aflame with the fire of your love constantly long for you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven, as the beginning and image of your Church is coming to perfection, and as a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
We offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For then we offer you this sacrifice of praise, where they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen.
Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord. Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory
by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious and grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's now offer one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I will not ever leave you, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Happy Solemnity. This is a big day for us. Typically, it still is. It's a holy day of obligation. So you got a freebie because it fell on a Sunday, so you didn't have to come during the week. So I hope you go celebrate. Do something special for today, for the Assumption of our Blessed Mother. This day, I'm certainly thinking a little bit of my mother. I have to brag on her a little bit. She actually made this vestment for me, and so I get to wear it on Marian days. Thank you. Just a couple of announcements. We will be starting a young adult group, which will be meeting on Thursday nights for those 18 to 26 years old. Thursday nights at 6 p.m. in the youth building. And Deacon, you'll be teaching your class at what time?
Yes, starting August 29th at 6:30 p.m. on Sunday evening. We'll be starting Genesis to Jesus class. It's a St. Paul Center series that we'll be doing. Me and Deacon Lewis will be moderating it for the class. So sign up in the office. And you get your workbook and any other book that you'd like to purchase.
Wonderful, thank you. So there's lots of opportunities to learn more about our faith. When we love somebody, we want to learn more about them. So it's the same with the Lord. He's ready to meet us all. There will be a solemn blessing for today, which I will give you if I can find it. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, who through the childbearing of the Blessed Virgin Mary, willed in his great kindness to redeem the human race, be pleased to enrich you with his blessing. Amen. May you know always and everywhere the protection of her, through whom you have been found worthy to receive the author of life.
Amen.
May you, who have devoutly gathered on this day, carry away with you the gifts of spiritual joys and heavenly rewards.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing with us Psalm 430, 430, Immaculate Mary. 430.
Yep.